Hello YouTube. I decided to pick up the camera because as it always happens when I start doing YouTube again, I say that again like it's been more than one time, but I get these random ideas throughout the day of things I should record that could be helpful for people. So when I was walking home from class, I also just had my final last class of college, which is amazing. I graduate next weekend. Can't believe it. That's a whole nother topic though. But so I thought it would be helpful to explain my current workout split. So I actually have it written down on my phone, so let me pull it up. But basically I work out 5 days a week and I've been doing that for a while, but I have kind of recently gotten back into a consistent lifting schedule within the past 3 weeks or so, 4 weeks I would say. So right now I have it written down right here so I can show you. You kind of can see from the glare. So on Mondays I'm doing legs. So I am doing a few different things. So I'll explain why I'm doing it, what I'm doing, and how it relates to my goals. So on Monday, I'm doing legs, and that's more of a glute focus. Usually I'll squat with the barbell, so I try to hit different weight goals every time. Right now I'm doing about 155 for sets of like five. I can do 185 for like two or three, and I would like to maybe get up to 200. I could even be there right now for a one rep max, but again, I can go into depth of that later if you're interested. So I think I'm pretty quad focused as with my body, and I want to really grow my glutes and hamstrings more. I really like having that glute hamstring kind of tie in. If you know what I'm talking about, where your hamstrings are very developed and apparent on your body, whereas my quads right now take up a lot of my legs, and that's like all you can see on the front, I feel like. So I'm doing glutes focused on Monday, like with squats, and I know that does hit my quads, but I like squatting. And then Tuesday, I'm doing back and biceps, because another one of my goals is to be able to decrease the weight that I'm doing for assisted pull-ups. So I really want to be able to do an unassisted pull-up. That's been a goal for a long time of mine. Does that even make sense? That's been a goal for a long time of mine. Yes. So I've been decreasing the weight little by little. Doing it just once a week I've already seen improvement, and it's exciting. So I do back and biceps because I also like to have my biceps grow a little bit in size. They're pretty well off right now, I would say, but just a little bit more in size. Wednesday, I usually will do legs again if they're not too sore. So another thing with this split is I kind of mix it up. If something is really sore, I'll just do a different body part on a different day. But Wednesday I'm doing legs, and I will focus more on hamstrings on this day. So I might do deadlifts with the barbell, but definitely would do deadlifts with the dumbbells and doing the seated hamstring curls and all that stuff. I may even do a little bit of hamstrings on Mondays now that I think about it, because I really want that tie-in. So I may start doing that next week. And then Thursdays I do chest. Well, Thursdays I do kind of all upper body. I just started that today. Today is Thursday, April 19th. So I kind of do all upper body, but I kind of focus on chest and triceps. So to explain it, I do like 50 push-ups as a warm-up, so I make sure I'm doing push-ups on Thursdays, and then I'll do a lot of tricep exercises, but then I'll also throw in some other and then maybe do like one set of like dumbbell incline, or not even incline, dumbbell bench press, just to work my chest a little bit, because I don't really feel like I need to work my chest as a woman. I don't want to have like a huge chest. That's not a huge goal of mine. That I think that's more for men personally. Not that men and females can't have the same goals and yada yada and all that. I wouldn't want to offend anyone, but I personally, if I can do push-ups and things like that, like I don't really need to have a super strong chest. Like I would like to have a good bench and whatnot, but I just can't focus on all three of those at once, as in the bench, deadlift, and squat. So I do that, and then like today I did a little bit of shoulders. I think my shoulders are pretty well off right now. I like how they are in size, but so I just did a little bit because I do just like training them, and I did like a couple bicep curls. So I basically did chest, triceps, biceps, and shoulders, a little bit of everything today, which was fun. And then on Fridays, usually my body is super sore and tired and I'm done with lifting for the week. So right now on Fridays, I've just been doing a LISS session, which is low intensity, steady state cardio. So last week was the first week I started it because the first week, last week was the first week I started this kind of cut. So I decided to just start out with one cardio session because if you start out with too much cardio, your body gets used to that and then you have to sustain it in order to sustain that weight, if that makes sense. Like your body is expecting to expend those calories. So if you don't, you're gonna hold on to those extra calories and maybe even gain weight. So that's why I am doing just one 20 to 30 minute session on Fridays, incline walk usually, because that has to do normally with the gym I'm at. When I have clients in the morning afterwards, I will train and they mainly have treadmills, so I do an incline walk and it's nice and chill. I get to watch TV, watch YouTube, things like that, listen to music. It's pretty relaxed, but I'm still working. My heart rate's still between 150 160. And then as time goes on, if I don't see a lot of progress with this little cut, I'm probably gonna add in one HIIT session a week, which is high intensity interval training, where you can do, just to explain it in short, you're going between jumping your heart rate up and bringing it down and then jump it back up and bring it down and going like that for about 15, however long minutes you want. So I may add one of those in, but right now I'm just doing one cardio session a week. And in addition to that, I do abs maybe twice a week. I stick to normally just like planks or things where your spine is straight and neutral, because there are some studies that too much kind of crunching, like herniated discs could come on in the future, but I mean, I'm not super into the science and studies behind all that, but I am just sticking to the planks because I noticed that my overall core kind of feels a lot more stable and structured when I do the planks. And then I'm really into yoga. I used to do hot yoga. That's how I kind of started working out. And I thought about becoming a teacher at one point. So I really loved it. I still really do love it. But so the point is that 3 or 4 times a week, like this week so far, I'm gonna do 4 times a week. I practice inversions. So that could be headstands, handstands, kind of like crow's pose where you have your knees up on your elbows and you're upside down. Anything where your head is below your heart is considered a inversion. So even downward dog is an inversion. So I practice that. So in short, I'm lifting 5 days a week, doing abs 2 days a week, yoga 3 to 4 days a week. And when I say that, practicing, I mean like 10 to 15 minutes of yoga, by the way. And then one cardio session a week may bump it up to 2. And so that was a very long-winded explanation, but that is what I'm currently doing and I've really enjoyed it so far. Again, I just started this cut, I'm calling it last Thursday, so it's been officially a week, and I've lost about 3 pounds, but I know a couple of those were from water weight to begin with. So I'm trying to kind of just feel it out, see how it goes, and I'm gonna bring you guys along with the whole journey, which I hope is helpful. And I've decided that I wanted to kind of name this as a series. So you know how a lot of YouTubers have series and they'll put like episodes and whatnot on their titles. So I'm trying to think of a series name for this. So I will try to come up with that by the next video. If you have any suggestions, please let me know because I would be happy to take them. But yeah, so that's it for this video talking about my split. I am sure you guys have seen my full days of eating and things like that, so let me know if you enjoy those and let me know what other content would be helpful for you guys. I really want to post helpful content in every video, so sorry, I keep looking outside. It's so nice out. I'll show you. You can't see super well, but I live right next to my campus and it's really beautiful and sunny outside for once. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, give this video a thumbs up. It helps support my channel. And then subscribe if you like the content and want to see more of it. So thanks so much, and I hope you have a great one. Bye.